Hello everyone, welcome to the Market Views update for 12th July 2018 from Brokerage Free. Let's have a look at the important points from yesterday's trading session. The markets ended on a flat note yesterday. Foreign institutional investors bought shares worth about Rs. 636 crores. Domestic investors bought shares worth about 515 crores. A doji pattern candlestick was formed on the daily charts. We'll see a bit more of this a couple of slides later. The US has imposed 10% tariffs on about 200 billion Chinese products that is being exported to the US by China. Let's have a look at Nifty. Nifty opened at 10,956 and closed at 10,948. Nifty made an intraday high of 10,976 and a low of 10,923. The market swung by about 53 points. The markets closed by about 1.05 points up from the previous day close of 10,947. Support levels at this point of time for Nifty is around 10,924 and 10,898. Resistance levels are at around 10,972 and 11,000. Bank Nifty support levels at this point of time is around 26,751 and 26,683. Bank Nifty resistance levels at this point of time is around 26,907 and 27,003. Let's have a look at what doji candlestick is. For us to have a doji candlestick, the open and close price are almost the same. This looks like a plus or a cross sign. The shadows of the candle are either small or non-existent. This basically indicates indecision both by the buyers and the sellers. Everyone is equally matched. The price does not seem to go anywhere. There are two interpretations for a doji candle. Either it indicates the sign of trend reversal, or the buyers or sellers are gaining momentum before they can continue the trend. Let's actually see the chart, how it looks like. So this is the daily charts for NSE Nifty, and here you can see we have a bullish trend, and on top of the bullish trend we have this candle, which is for yesterday. The market opened at 10,956 and it closed at 10,948. But if you see, after it opened, it has gone on a high of about 10,976, and also it has gone on a low of 10,923. What it means is that the bulls or the buyers, they keep pushing the prices up, whereas the bears, they keep pushing it down, and so both of them are equally matched. There are equal number of buyers and sellers, and because of which the price, though it goes up and down, it comes and manages to stay close to where it opened. So the difference between yesterday's closing and the day before yesterday's closing is only about 1 point. See, this is where it closed yesterday, and this is where it closed day before yesterday, and this is where it closed yesterday. Roughly about 1 or 2 points is what the difference is, and this looks like a plus sign or a cross sign. So this type of a candlestick is called a doji type pattern candlestick. And when this happens, it generally means that the market is stabilizing before it can continue the momentum, or it is a sign of trend reversal. We'll see how the markets evolve today. Let's have a look at long buildup. Long buildup happens when people open long positions, and because of which the price and the open interest, both of them increase. Bharati Infratel has a change in open interest of about 5.98% and with a change of about 3.88%. Hindustan Unilever has a change in open interest of 3.06 and a percentage change of 1.85% in its price, which is 31.15 rupees. We have three more stocks which has a change in open interest of more than 2%: Adani Port, Kotak Mahindra Bank Limited, and HDFC Bank Limited. The price difference for HDFC Bank is marginal. Kotak Mahindra is about 1.08%, which is 14.8. Adani Port also has a price difference of about 0.08%. Other notable stocks include HCL Technologies, Infosys, and Wipro appearing on this list as well. So, if you are trading in these stocks, please take note that people are taking long positions in these stocks. Reliance Industries, if you see, this also appears on this list. And recently, Reliance Industries has posted their quarterly results which is very good, and because of which the stock in about 1 or 2 weeks ago, it was only about 960 or 970, and now it has come up till about 1038. That also appears in this list. So if you're trading in these stocks, please take note that people are taking long positions in these stocks. Long unwinding happens when people exit their long positions, and because of that, the price decreases and the open interest also decreases. So we do not have too many stocks in this list. iShares Motors appears in this list with a change in open interest of 1.97% and the percentage change of 0.45% in its price, which is 128.5 rupees. We have Bharti Airtel Limited also appearing on this list. We have State Bank of India and Tata Steel, Tata Motors also appear on this list. So if you're trading in these stocks, please take note that people are exiting the long positions in these stocks. Short buildup happens when people open short positions, and because of which the price goes down but the open interest increases. So here we have UltraTech Cement, which has a change in open interest of 8.18%. Which is a significant number, but the price difference is only marginal. Irrespective of the price difference being marginal, the change in open interest is significant, which is 8% or so. We have about three more stocks which has a change in open interest of more than 5%, which is Titan, ITC and UPL. UPL has a change in its price of 5.28%, which is also significant. We have Titan with a price difference of 2.8%, which is 23.35 rupees. That is also significant. We have a good number of stocks, about three stocks with a change in open interest of 3%. Cipla, Bharat Petroleum and Hindustan Petroleum come under this list. We have IndusInd Bank also. We have quite a few stocks above 2% as well. GAIL, HDFC, IndusInd Bank Limited, about 2%. And one which is Bajaj Finserv is close to about 2%. So if you're trading in these stocks, please take note that people are creating short positions in these stocks, and the prices for these stocks may be going down the near short term. Short covering happens when people close their short positions, and people are closing their short positions. The price has a marginal increase, but the open interest decreases. We have Tata Consultancy Services, which saw a change in open interest of about 8.65%, which is a significant, and also percentage change of 5.59%, which is 104.8 rupees. Tata Consultancy Services recently posted their results, and they have done very well. And this is possibly because people have bought a lot of Tata Consultancy shares, and they are just getting out of it. We have India Bulls in this list, Tech Mahindra, Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, Yes Bank and Z Entertainment Limited. So if you're trading in these stocks, please take note that people are closing their short positions in these stocks. Let's have a look at the world markets. The American markets ended on a negative note. As of yesterday, Dow Jones was down by 0.88%, S&P 500 down by 0.71%, Canada down by 0.77%, Mexico was marginally up by 0.07%, Brazil and Chile were down by 0.62% and 0.48% respectively. The European markets were largely negative as of yesterday, and England down by 1.3%, Europe down by 1.16%, France down by 1.48%, Germany down by 1.53%, and Swiss down by 0.98%. Let's have a look at the Asian markets. The Asian markets were largely positive yesterday. Japan up by 1.15%, Hong Kong up by 0.49%, China up by 1.27%, Mumbai Sensex and NSE Nifty was up by about 0.07 and 0.11% respectively. At the time of preparing this report, Singapore Nifty was up by 27.5 points, which is roughly about 0.25%. If this is to give any indication, the markets should open at around the same range and probably be range bound today. Let's see how the markets evolve today. Thank you for watching this edition of Market Views Update from Brokerage Free. Invest wisely for a better future. Good luck with your trades. Thank you.